JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for October the 27th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded mixed against the other major currencies on Tuesday during the Asian session. Wednesday it gained versus CAD and NZD, while it underperformed against CHF, AUD and GBP. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the euro and the Japanese yen. Now, the weakening of the kiwi and the loonie, combined with the strengthening of the franc, suggests a risk-off trading activity. However, the strengthening of the Aussie and the pound points otherwise. So, with the performance in the FX world painting a blurry picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU indices were a sea of green, with Wall Street later trading virtually unchanged. Risk appetite deteriorated even further during the Asian session today, with all indices under our radar entering negative waters. In our view, the change in investors' morale during the Asian trading session may have been the result of the more than expected acceleration in Australia's trimmed mean and weighted mean CPI rates during the third quarter. Although the headline rate slowed to 3% from 3.8%, both the trimmed mean and weighted mean rates jumped to 2.1% year-over-year, entering the RBA's target range of 2-3% for the first time since 2016. The Aussie spiked up at the time of the release, perhaps as market participants got more convinced that the RBA could alter its narrative on interest rates very soon. Up until the latest gathering, the RBA has been repeatedly noting that interest rates are unlikely to start rising before 2024, but recently investors have been anticipating interest rates to start rising sometime in the middle of next year, and the inflation numbers may have added more credence to their view. So, how did the Australian CPIs affect the broader market sentiment? Maybe the fact that the RBA could start raising interest rates much sooner than previously thought triggered speculation that other more hawkish central banks could proceed with even more aggressive and faster tightening, and that's why Asian investors abandoned equities today. The fact that another Chinese property developer Modern Land defaulted on bond payments, besides the well-known situation with Evergrande, and the latest announcement on real estate taxes in China may have also weighed on sentiment. Now, today the main item on the agenda may be the Bank of Canada interest rate decision. At its prior gathering, the bank left the door for further tapering wide open, despite some participants expecting a delay mainly due to the economic contraction in the second quarter. Even Governor Tiff Macklem said that he and his colleagues are moving closer to a time when continuing to add stimulus through quantitative easing won't be necessary, adding more credence to the view that more policy withdrawal could be delivered at this gathering. Since then, Canadian data have been coming in on the bright side, with the Bank of Canada's Business Outlook survey revealing that business sentiment hit a new record, the employment returning close to pre-crisis levels, and inflation accelerating even further in September. In our view, this makes the case for another tapering move this week nearly certain, and suggest a relatively sanguine language in the statement accompanying the decision. Now, with the quantitative easing tapering process expected to be over in December, anything suggesting that interest rates could start rising early next year could support further the Canadian dollar, which recently has been fueled by the rally in oil prices. Let's not forget that Canada is the world's fifth largest oil producing nation, while it holds the fourth place in terms of exports. Now, as for tonight, during the Asian session Thursday, we have another central bank deciding on monetary policy, and this is the Bank of Japan. However, with Japanese inflation near zero, well below the bank's target of 2%, we don't expect any material changes, neither to the actual policy measures, nor to the language in the accompanying statement. Once again, the yen may not react to the outcome and stay driven by the yield differentials between Japan and other major nations. With the global surge in inflation triggering a rally in global government bond yields and the Bank of Japan maintaining a ceiling to its own yields, we do see the case for the Japanese currency to continue underperforming against the other major currencies. Now, as for the rest of today's events, from the US we get durable goods orders for September. Headline orders are forecast to have slid 1.1% month over month after increasing 1.8% in August, but the core rate is anticipated to have ticked up to 0.4% month over month from 0.3%. The Energy Information Administration report on crude oil inventories for last week is also coming out, and the forecast points to a 1.914 million barrels increase, following a 0.431 million decline the week before. However, bearing in mind that the American Petroleum Institute reported a 2.318 million inventory built, we would consider the risks surrounding the Energy Information Administration forecast as tilted to the upside. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.